a girlfriend sandwich. I already showed you how to make the boyfriend sandwich. Well, you know what? We're hungry too, so stick around. So let's get right to it here. We're making the girlfriend sandwich. So what I have here is some Canadian bacon, because it has the word bacon in it, but it's 98% fat-free, but we like the word bacon, so we're gonna use that. It's also round. We're gonna put three kinds of cheese, a slice of Swiss, a slice of provolone, a slice of Munster, and either I'm gonna eat this or it's going in too. We'll use mustard, cilantro, avocado, and this mixture I have here of rice wine vinegar and olive oil and a little lemon juice, which we're gonna brush on. And of course, we've gotta brush it on something, which is going to be this three-seed whole wheat bread, because we wanna be healthy, okay? And we're gonna use cream cheese. I know that's not healthy, but this is a girlfriend sandwich. You wanna wow her. You don't feed this to anyone every day, but you wanna wow her, you want something creamy and delicious, this is what's gonna do it. You can use low fat, non-fat, doesn't matter. I use the regular because I don't eat it very often, so I like something that tastes really good. So let's just go ahead and spread this puppy out here. Two pieces of bread. So the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm brushing lightly this mixture I told you about. This is just gonna give it this kind of delicious, zesty, kind of semi-salad-y feel. Let's just tap it on there a little bit, okay? So now we're gonna go for the cream cheese. You don't have to slather it on. And of course, if you are someone who doesn't eat dairy products, you can leave the cream cheese out and just go straight for the mustard and maybe use a little more of this. So you can be creative. What I'm saying isn't set in stone. In fact, I would hope that you would say, oh, I like that, but I don't like that. And then you make your own version. Here, just spread it on like this, not too thick. I think I'll just kind of create a little glue there. Okay, so let's go on the next one. I'm putting two thin layers on each side. This can be messy. I have a towel over there for that very reason. Okay, so next, mustard. Mustard makes everything taste better. Okay, what next? How about some cheese on this side? And I think we're just gonna go for this much cheese. That's three slices. Some cilantro. And I'm putting it here on the side that has the mustard and the cream cheese because it's going to be kind of sticky and it's gonna stay there a little better. So now for the Canadian bacon, let me see, I have five pieces here. Let's see if that's enough. If not, I'm gonna get some more, but it looks like that's perfect. Gonna look a little like that. You could add another one if you want. Okay, now I add avocado to everything. You don't have to do that, but I'm going to. I'm assuming that your girlfriend likes avocado. And also, one good thing about avocado is it's very creamy. So I just don't like dry sandwiches. So that's why I add the cream cheese. So I'm just gonna mush this on here, and you can kind of mush it ahead of time if you want, but you know, you're probably wanting to get this job done pretty quickly, right? So let's just get that on there, and I shall show you what that looks like. And I can add tomatoes or something on here too, but you know what? I'm looking around. This is perfect, because I'll show you how I'm gonna cut it. So now let's just squish that together. We've got one big, big sandwich. Let me come around and show you. So here, we've got this big sandwich here, all sides. But what we're gonna do is we're gonna cut it up so that it's pretty. That's part of it. We're girls, we want things pretty. I could do triangles, I could do just slices. I'm gonna kinda do these long slices. And your girlfriend's gonna feel like you gave her so much food. And if that's the case, which it probably is, because this is a humongo sandwich, I cut this into five different pieces. So what I would do, because you certainly don't want her to think that you think she's fat and you don't want to give her too much, is save the end pieces for yourself. Give your girlfriend the pretty pieces. Now, if you give her a sandwich like this, she's probably going to want something to drink with it, like some water. I have some ice water here, and I just put a slice of lemon in it. You can put lime or cucumber. Mm, very refreshing. But she's probably going to want something else, too. Something, let's put this down over here. Something a little refreshing or crunchy. So that's why I got out this cucumber. So as you can see, a girlfriend sandwich is more than a sandwich. You've got to do the full picture. We like variety. We want to know that you worked hard, that you care. We want to know that you made some effort. So let's just go ahead and slice a few more of these. I think that's enough. Let's do that. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to put these on the tray. And you notice I picked something kind of quirky, a little quirky tray here. I'm going to push those over. Put these right here. Now, if you give her this, she's going to want something sweet. So, okay. Now what? What can we give her that's sweet? I have an idea. How about some berries? So if you give her some berries, she's going to want some yogurt. Or if you give her some yogurt, she's going to want some berries. So want to give her some yogurt and berries. So all I'm going to do is I wash these are blackberries. I'm going to pour them on top. Right here, we have yogurt and cucumber and a sandwich that we sliced into three ways, and she's probably going to share one of these with you. But if she doesn't share one with you, well, you have some leftover, especially if you use that really big bread. It looks kind of like a little baby sandwich right there. And you can go ahead and put some of the cucumber on here for yourself. And now I have something else that I think is really, really tasty, that if you didn't want to do the yogurt and berries, what about figs? Figs are the fruit of love. So this is how we're going to serve the fruit of love. This is how I like to cut figs. I just cut the little end off, which is actually edible. But I'm going to cut these into really nice circles. So again, I cut the end off. Really nice circles. Doesn't look as good. Okay, cut, cut, cut. Okay, so now that we have these all cut, I'm placing them on a plate. You see how pretty they are, how perfectly round they are. And I know I talk about that all the time, but I can't help it. So there we go. The fruit of love. Those you can eat with your hands. You can feed them to her, and maybe she'll feed you one. So once you've fed your girlfriend this delicious girlfriend sandwich that you made all by yourself, and she's so appreciative, you know, she may want some chocolate. They're made from the round cocoa beans, so you might want to be prepared. Mmm, this one's really good. Has cherries inside. Once you've given her some chocolate, she's still probably going to want some flowers. Flowers. Visit Runorama.com for a free round diet and much, 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 much more. Roundorama.com. Wow, I get it. Everything's round. But why? Why is it round? Well, you kind of have to go there to see what it's all about. So, roundorama.com.